going.
Thank you.
fast. To improvise. Don't worry, I'll think of something. Must have missed something. Years, think fast. like seconds are fleeting. Love a good puzzle. I was out of sync. This isn't my first time being here. Don't worry, I'll think of something. fast. Time to improvise. I do love a good puzzle. Think of something. Like seconds. Time to improvise. Thank you. Let's slow this down. Think fast.
I don't know how to. You ever watch Welcome to the NHK?
No.
It's very good. But it's also a very like brutal look into hikikomori life and culture and the different types of hikikomoris.
It's neat, right?
Yeah. So like there's like a character who like lives in the second floor of his sister's house. Like she's taking care of him. Like she's his enabler. And he like fucking throws tantrums and he's like slamming his he's like she'll be downstairs and she's like exactly like 100% exactly like that, except it was really painful for like an entire arc of that show. You're just like fuck. But it was the culmination of that, the end of that character's like growth. It was really good. Like
what's that
the whole show was really good.
The mangaka white haired girl, that show where she's that, but you're supposed to love her because she's cute, and you're supposed to fuck her while you have her trapped in your house. It's fucking the creepiest thing ever.
Excuse me?
You know what I'm talking about. It's the incredibly popular thing. Fuck off.
I don't know what you're talking about.
By the guy that made
My scared.
Little Sister Can't Be This Cute.
Arrow Manga Sensei?
Arrow Manga Sensei, yes. She's that. She's a hikikomori. And she throws tantrums and
I guess yes, she is a people to not worry, except she's a cute little girl, so it doesn't read as being a toxic, horrible human.
Did you say this show is
and the dude is worse because he wants to keep he works to keep her trapped too.
Well, she's not even like a neat though. She like makes a living drawing. Like she has a job.
James, you were saying this show's like intense. Is that what you're saying?
Yes, Welcome to the NHK is very emotionally draining. It has fucked up shit and like deals with issues like suicide and depression.
Check it out, yeah.
So if you've ever had someone in your life who was suicidal or if you've ever been depressed, it's very impactful. But it's also very motivating. I think at times it's a little it's a little too over Japanese idealistic in how it views how hikikomori culture should be tackled, but it's comes from a good place. Like, it's a very enjoyable show. Honestly, I would recommend it for anime night, but I don't want to be sad. And it's like 24 episodes. So. Yeah, it was, I think, at some point. Might have been on Netflix for a bit.
It's got like a page, but the episodes are not there.
Huh. I wonder where I watched it. I don't remember. Steins Gate is number 2 in rankings and popularity number 9. Hmm? What?
It used to be on Crunchyroll, but now it's not.
Well, I guess it just got old and they didn't want to push it anymore.
It is. I guess it's on Funimation. Aren't they like merging or something?
Sony, which owns Funimation, now also bought Crunchyroll.
Put it all together.
They did a collaboration.
Keep torrenting, my friends. It will only get worse.
Did you guys have fun?
I wonder what Crunchyroll services will look like in like 4 years.
I do not know. Good question. At this rate, everything will be owned by Amazon. Oh, that's probably what'll happen. Alright. Talk to you guys later.
Night.
Night Charlie.
Ugh. Did I have I told you the story of how I watched Welcome to the NHK?
No. Well, actually maybe, but I don't remember.
I think I have shared this before. There was a cute girl in a math class in one of my math classes in college who sat next to me. And she was like, "Oh, yeah, you gotta watch this." Like, she's found out I liked anime, and she's like, "I like anime." We were talking a little bit. She's like, "You gotta watch this show, Welcome to the NHK." So I Colin and I sat down, banged it out after a couple sessions. We really binged that one too. It was pretty watchable. And like, it's this show about like, you know, neets turning their life around and like being social and like changing their lives. And like, I talked to this girl later. I was like, "Yeah, I watched it. It was really good." And
yeah.
and after I had shared with her that I had watched it, like between that time, I found out that she was like a personal trainer.
Yep.
Or like an aspiring personal trainer. Like after I had like confirmed, like after she'd received the acknowledgement that I had watched that show, she like basically like just stopped talking to me or like lost all like continued interest to motivate me. She was like, "Ah, my job is done. I got him to watch the neat motivational show."
Yeah.
I was like, "What the fuck?"
Yeah.
Man. That was most of my experience with women in college.
People are dumb.
Yeah. There's another girl I tutored. One of my other math classes. Tutored her, and she's like, "I'm a lesbian," and I'm like, "I'm tutoring you." That's how it started. Like, I tutored her for the last half of the semester to make sure she passed. And I was like, "You want to hang out?" Like, more or less, like platonic. Like, yes. I don't have friends of the opposite gender. This is like, she's like, "I'm a lesbian and I smoke weed." I'm like, "Okay." That's that then. Then before I knew it, I was too old to be cool and hang out with the people at community college. Anime motivational quote from Welcome to the NHK. "If you can't be self-confident, then just imagine the person you're speaking to is even more of a failure than you think you are."
Is that supposed to, that's a joke, right?
Don't know. Believe in the you who believes in me. I do remember now, the protagonist in Welcome to the NHK is pretty terrible. But I mean, he is a neat, but he's pretty awful to, like, a lot of people. You kind of spend most of the show going, like, "Jesus, fuck. Like, fuck this guy. Just let him rot. How could he not pick up that was not okay?" My ears are fucking ringing, dude. I don't know how to...
This is the guy I just beat. Ever... I just realized.
Hmm.
Alright, I'm gonna watch my Hololive.
The real cooked meatloaf. Subaru is playing Zelda right now. I got content. I'm glad you liked Mononoke.
It was really...
You are a true man of taste. Charlie's a dirty Neanderthal.
He just did himself a disservice there.
Charlie's a dirty Neanderthal, and Andrew just, I just accept Andrew. I accept Andrew for who he is.
I agree with Andrew on a lot of things, and I agree on all the other things. Interesting. But we also probably did him a disservice by watching such a long movie so late, honestly. Mm-hmm. I really think that probably had a big impact.
Well, I would jump on that chance to blame you, but I mean, we really showed up around the same time, so it's fine.
Yeah, they did tell me that that you had been on for 1 minute when I got on.
Yeah, I outed myself when you came in. I was like, oh yeah, I've only been here like 2 minutes, man. It's cool. But I had been around the whole time. I just went. I like 8 o'clock showed up, and no one was here yet. So I finally just went and took a shower. Showed up again. But yeah, I'm glad you liked it. I'm sure Andrew appreciated it for all the right reasons. And I don't really blame anyone for not liking Princess Mononoke. It is fucking, it's slow. It's paced and measured and it, but I don't know. I found it. I find that it's a fascinating movie. I mean, it's very engaging for me. But that's because I'm a furry, nature-loving faggot. So I'm like, will the forest be saved? Will the humans coexist? I could see a lot of people just like watching a movie like this and being like, I don't give a fuck about some feudal Japanese relations. I like little things like... I really like ancient, like, Japanese tribal culture, or, like, the cusp and end of that era. That kind of stuff. I fucking love it. And there's not enough, like... You'll see, like, little nods to it in certain sexy robot body, and then I talked to, like, all my crew members about it, and then I, like, started a mission and had to get up for moving some shit around the house, and then I didn't come back to it, and then I didn't start playing again.
Yeah, that's not a good one. Alright, thanks.
See ya!
Things are inevitable. Accept a lesser world.